Oh, so green. I love spring. Hello, my brothers and sisters on the Dragon's Path. My name is Tim Heyer and I believe in dragons. And something that I will never do on my path of the dragon is disrespect a dragon. Disrespect, I heard that a lot from other people. Most of the time they are not on the dragon's path. Or maybe in the early stages of their path, when they don't really know their dragon yet. So they make the mistake of disrespecting a dragon. So like they do a seance, they do rituals, and they invoke the dragon. The dragon spirit. Or at least try to do that. There are certain spells that are literally dragging the dragon out of the dragon realms to them. And that doesn't end well, because don't never forget the dragon is for 50% darkness, and they won't let themselves be intimidated by human beings that don't have or barely have a connection with you. The dragon. So don't disrespect them. I've seen that a lot, disrespecting a dragon. And dragons, they have their pride, they are proud beings, proud spirits, and they don't let themselves be forced, or they don't let themselves be treated like a pet, because that is often a mistake that I often see, that I actually very much see, actually all the time. Like they can give the dragon orders, or that they listen to them like some kind of a slave. And that is what the dragon is not. The dragon is a very free being. And if you are trying to invoke the dragon, and you just say, "Dragon, you have to come with me now to be in my rituals." And whoa, the dragon, if there is an opening to the dragon's realms that they make, and a dragon can come through, then I hope that you are in your circle, because that won't end well. The dragon won't or never let themselves be treated like a dog. Never. So remember that. If you are new on the dragon's path, just never force a dragon. Just give them the respect they deserve. They deserve a lot of respect. They are the beings of nature. They are the beings that are still next to some humans. And rituals always have to come with a lot of respect for the dragon. A lot of respect that comes from both sides. Not just you, for example, you have draconic energy inside of you. You have this pride inside of you. You have this feeling inside of you of a dragon. Would you actually give them the satisfaction of you coming to their rituals and do whatever they ask, because they are above you? That is something where the dragon doesn't work well with. That is the thought that you are above the dragon. Like I say, a lot of times you are equal to them, and only equal to the ones they have selected, the one they have chosen. The chosen ones are equal. All the other people that they don't have a connection with are lesser beings. You and the dragon and the gods. And everyone else is lesser, even though you have to respect every life, human and animal. They are lesser. They are just less, they are beneath. And if they don't have a connection and try to force the dragon with spells and something like that, and open the dragon's gate. Yeah, I've seen that. A dragon can touch us. A dragon can very much touch us, actually, even to the ones they don't have a connection with. If they are so triggered, the dragon can be triggered. If they are so triggered in a negative way, they will try to even pull their last energy to give you something that you don't want. But that is most of the time to the people that don't have a connection with. So for witches and some things like that, witches from other paths, they are interested. They want to invoke the dragon alongside a lot of gods and goddesses and demigods and blah blah blah, and Odin and Zeus. The dragon, like I said, is very proud. Don't invoke more. It's just the dragon. She put your mind on the dragon. Everything is a dragon. Some people like to invoke several gods, several paths in just one ritual. And some people, dragons, or it's mine, it's my path, it can be me. But you have to have your attention 100% on the dragon. You love the dragon. Try to show this love to them. Try to express this love to them. Not by invoking and doing some kind of a magical ritual that is very, very powerful that no one else can do. It's not about power on the dragon's path. It's about connection and love. And if you don't have that, if you don't show that to the dragon, and being mean and being let themselves be treated like a dog or a pet, that is not the dragon's way. You don't want to be treated like that, so why are they treating the dragon like that? Such a proud being. Respect. Something that everyone deserves, but the dragon even more. And it hurts me sometimes when I see spells that say, come to me, and now it has to be. Me, as a draconic energy, I would say, F you. But there are dragons who doesn't leave it like that. It doesn't leave it that way. Just want to let you know that you don't command a dragon. They are not slaves, especially not for humans they don't have a connection with. Dragons are free beings. They do whatever they want. If you ask the dragon something, then it has to be humble. It has to be sincere and out of love. Not for the quest of searching power and the quest of growing more and more. Your growth will come. It will come eventually. It will come when you will least expect. When you least expect it, your growth will happen. When it's forced like that, don't do that. Forcing is never good. If your feelings are forced, the dragon will know. Don't force anything. So respect is the key. Respect is everything, my brothers and sisters. So keep the respect for the dragon. I know you have a lot of respect for the dragon, because you have this draconic energy and you should feel it. You are also a very proud being, a proud spirit that is so much draconic energy in him. You should understand that. You are not a pet, they are not a pet. You both are actually together with the gods. You are divine. And you never command a god. My brothers and sisters, be blessed.